Okay, so in this next section, I like to define the swap and the swap rate. So this is the textbook version. Yeah, so it has some idealizations, which I can maybe make a few comments on later. The swap is a very important financial product because it is heavily traded on the market. So maybe I can also make comments on this later, while this is a popular product. We will see this maybe in a few minutes. So very important product because it has a certain advantage. And from this definition, so the swap is the exchange of a floating rate payment and fixed payment. So what is here is that I receive, so if I'm valuing this from my perspective, positive amounts are receiving, negative amounts are paying. I receive a floating rate payment and I pay some constant payment, say S. So one guy is called here the fixed rate and the other one is called the floating rate. Since all these guys are interest rates, so unitless per time, I have to multiply with the time span of a period. If I have my period discretization, I pay the amount that is fixed at the beginning. So in TI, it is fixed. I pay it at the end of the period. So again, I have here payment time. It's paid in TI plus one. Okay, so maybe that is here a small red dot, and it is fixed in TI. Yeah, so this guy here is fixed at the beginning of the period TI. So you see, if you decompose this into M times L times period length, this is just the floater, the floating rate. And if you decompose it to the minus M times SI, so this times period length, this is just our fixed coupon payment. S is just a constant, which we sometimes call fixed swap rate. Here, SI can be different in every period, like the CI in my fixed coupon bond, but often it is the same number for every period. Yeah? So it's just a flat stream of payment that is known from beginning. And here is a variable payment of stochastic objects that is fixed at the beginning of the period. Okay, since this is just a linear combination of things that we have already valued, I can immediately write down the value. The value is this amount multiplied with the zero coupon bond price that corresponds to the payment time, where I replace the fixing time with the valuation time, because that was what we proved for the floating rate payment. In the definition, I had a payer swap. So this object is called payer swap because it pays the fixed rate. This definition, payer or receiver, relates to who receives the fixed rate or who pays the fixed rate. So there is also the receiver swap, which is just flipping the payments, or it's the notional is negative. Yeah, so you have a minus M. Okay, so this guy here is the payer swap. Well, that's not difficult for us. We have it inside the M. Yeah, the M could be just the minus amount. Another term is that sometimes we decompose the payment streams into separate payment streams, and these are called legs. Yeah? So the payment stream can be decomposed into two different legs. This here is the floating leg. This is the floating leg, which pays the variable, so floating amount. And this here is the fixed leg, which pays the fixed amount in every time period. So if you like to draw a cash flow diagram of this swap, well, I have drawn a variable amount with maybe some kind of wiggling arrow that gives me the cash flow. Okay, and if this is a payer swap, I receive the variable amount and I pay the fixed amount. So if it's positive, the arrow goes up. If it's negative, the arrow goes down. So it is a little bit like having these cash flows. Okay, so for a period discretization, yeah, so we have here some TI plus one, and so on. And this is the period start, the first period start. So this here is my T1. Do I start in T1? Yeah. Okay. Okay, I already mentioned, we already know the value. It is the valuation of the floater, so which we already did, and the valuation of the fixed payments. So to value it, we just multiply with the zero coupon bond that pays 1 unit in payment time observed in evaluation time. With the little thing for which we did this proof that the interest rate is fixed now here in this expression in little t, because I like to have something that is FT measurable. Huh? So this here is an evaluation in little t, so it's FT measurable. It's known in little t, so it sounds so complicated, but just it's known in little t. So this is the valuation, and the proof is already done by our previous theorem. So we have the value of the swap. And now comes an important question. So let's assume that all the swap rates in my definitions are the same. So Si is always the same as. So like here in the drawing, now all these quantities here are now the same. Yeah. So this is my Si. They are constants. Yeah? So this here is an S. So then I can ask myself, for which S is the value of this object zero? So, of course, if I take S zero and interest rates are positive, then this has a positive value. But since there's a minus here, if I make S very large, I will generate a negative value. No? And so I can find a value in between where this value is zero. Okay, so let's define this S in time little t. So time little t is my valuation time. Let's define this little s for which this guy has value zero. So I just need to plug in this s in the valuation formula. So my valuation formula is this thing here. So this expression should be zero. So I have a sum of this difference, this minus this. So I can make this a sum M times L multiplied with delta TI, yeah, so the time span multiplied with the zero coupon bond, minus a sum M times the sum of all S's multiplied with this. So I can make this difference. And then I can make s move in front, and I just divide by the sum of ti plus 1 minus ti pti plus 1. And I have the expression for s. So this is the solution. So maybe there is an m here in front, yeah, and an m in front here, and that cancels. So this is the s for which the value of this swap is 0. So of course it is the value of the floating leg. This is the value of the floating leg. This is the value of the floater divided by the value of the fixed leg for s equals 1. Yeah, this would be the value of the fixed leg for s equals 1. The value of the fixed leg with a different s is s times this. Yeah? So I see if I divide by this, I have the solution. And if you recall the value of the floating leg, if you plug in the definition of L here, then this is a telescope sum. So it is the value of the bond at the beginning minus the bond at the end divided by the sum of the bonds in between and at the end, all scaled with the period lengths. Yeah, this is a strange question. Yeah? But the funny thing is that this guy can be interpreted again as an interest rate. Okay, a small definition. So I now define this as the so-called par swap rate. So the par swap rate, or often just called swap rate, is this number, this object, for which the value of the swap is 0. Of course, this number depends on my time discretization, because you see that the time discretization enters into the definition. It depends on my tenor discretization. And also note that this object is a stochastic process, or if I plug in the little t, it is a random variable. Yeah? Okay, why that? Because all these objects we see here, interest rate, zero Cooper bond, they are random variables. Because at every time, the solution of this question can be a different one. At every time and every omega, the solution can be a different one. It depends on what future interest rates we observe. The swap rate, so the number that puts the value of the swap to 0, is a different one. So this guy that is here underneath, which is to some extent the fixed leg for swap rate 1, also has a special name. This thing is sometimes called the swap annuity. And if you take a close look, you see that this swap annuity is a portfolio of zero Cooper bonds. Yeah? It is a linear combination of zero Cooper bonds where the amount of zero Cooper bonds is just the period length. Yeah? So the fraction of these that you buy of these guys. The thing is that the object which we have just defined can be interpreted as an interest rate. So we have yet another definition of an interest rate. So similar to what we did before, we defined this rolling bond investment, and then we asked ourselves, okay, what is the performance of this rolling bond investment? So we could define the backward looking rate. Here we define a financial product, the swap, and we could ask ourselves, what is the value, the rate S that puts this to 0? And that is now a special interest rate, the swap rate. And to illustrate you the interpretation, what is this guy doing? If you have the floating leg here, of course, these payments can be different. Yeah? They are at different times. So they depend on what interest rate we observe for future times, and they are stochastic. And the stochasticity, I observed this at, say, some point little t, I observe the expected amount that is paid when I pay this interest rate. So I have a certain expectation. And now I can ask myself, okay, what is the constant payment that corresponds to this such that it has the same value? So I'm looking at the fixed leg that has constant payment that has the same value. Okay, this is the question which we had solved here. So this means that my fixed payment is somehow the average. Yeah. So this is the corresponding S. Well, this is my S of little t. If these guys here are my L ti, ti plus one, observed in little t. Yeah. My expected payment. Okay, so somehow this S is for a larger period, the average that has to be paid at every period. Well, you know that the green ones were the floating rate payments that exactly compensate for the time span. And this is somehow averaging these payments. Also, if you spot here again the definition, you see that, yeah, you see this here is a sum of the interest rate payments multiplied with a certain factor, a certain weight. Yeah? Time span and zero coupon bond that corresponds to payment time. And this here below is the sum of these weights. So this here is just a weighted average. So you see already from the definition that our intuition is correct. This here is a weighted average. Every interest rate is weighted with the time span and some factor that corresponds to the payment time, which is what we do in the valuation. Every interest rate is weighted with this factor that will give us the valuation, and we divide by the sum of all factors. Yeah, so you see that here the sum of the blue stuff is one. Yeah? So it is a convex combination. So the swap rate is a special convex combination of the forward rates. Wow, interesting. Interesting object. So the swap rate is a convex combination of the forward rates. So from this definition, you see that it is the sum alpha k lk, and these weights alpha k are just what we had there. So every interest rate is multiplied with the zero coupon bond and the period length, and we divide then by the swap annuity. Funny thing, the weights are of course also stochastic. Yeah. All these guys are random variable. Later, we will do fancy approximation, assuming these weights to be constant, yeah, and derive some stuff with Ito's lemma. Okay, but so that's the reason why this lemma here is important. Yeah? So it's this convex combination. Up to now, the lemma is important because it gives you a very good intuition what the swap rate is. Yeah? It is some average interest rate for the future that somehow also accounts for, in the averaging, accounts for the difference in payment time. So the swap rate depends on the time discretization. Sometimes I drop this, yeah, and I just mentioned the starting point and the end point. Yeah, so I assume a certain time discretization, but to be precise here, if you go back, so you see that it actually depends. Yeah. So a swap rate associated with quarterly payments is not the same as a swap rate associated with semi-annual payments. Yeah. Okay. So the proof of this little lemma is trivial. Yeah. And that's maybe it for today. In the next session, we can generalize a little bit the definition of the swap. So what we will do in this generalization is we will, for example, replace the forward rate with a backward looking rate and ask ourselves, okay, then we have a swap on a backward looking rate. How does this compare to the other swap?